Publisher 2010 is a program in the Microsoft Office suite. It can be used to create publications like name badges, brochures, menus, and more. If you're familiar with Microsoft Office, you probably know that you can create these materials in Word. However, there are certain advantages to Publisher. For example, it gives you more control over the size, shape, and layout of your document, whether you're working on a tiny business card or a multi-page newsletter. Unfortunately, Publisher 2010 lacks some of the features that are present in Word 2010, like themes, shape styles, and advanced photo editing. The interface, however, has been updated to include the new ribbon, which is the collection of tools and features at the top of the screen. Here, everything you need is divided into tabs to make it easier to navigate. If you look closely at the upper left corner above the ribbon, you'll find the Quick Access toolbar. This little toolbar is designed to give you access to frequently used commands like save and undo, no matter where you are on the ribbon. Now let's take a look at the work area and the publication itself. That's the space in the center where I've already started putting together a newsletter. If your publication has multiple pages, you can navigate between them using the pane on the left. To zoom in or out on your publication, or change the page view, use the controls in the bottom right corner. Here's what they look like up close. I'm just going to click and drag the slider to zoom in, then scroll up, so we can check out some of the tools designed to help you with your layout. First, we have rulers, above and to the left. These make it easier to align things like text and images in your publication. If you don't see the rulers in your copy of Publisher, go to the View tab, then check the box next to Rulers. Also in this group, we have editing tools like baselines. See the dotted lines on my publication? Basically, everything in this group is designed to help you control the layout of your content. Each tool can be turned on or off by checking the box, as you can see, and they won't appear in your printed publication. The other tool I'd like to show you is guides. Guides are thin dotted lines that can be used to align various things in your publication. The blue ones mark the edges or margins of the printable area. These are created automatically when you set your margins or insert a page. The green lines are custom guides that you can create yourself. All you have to do is click, hold, and drag your mouse away from the ruler. See how it works? To move a custom guide, click and drag it again. Finally, I'd like to show you where to go to do things like saving your file. If you're familiar with Publisher 2007, you may have noticed that the Office button is missing. That's because it's been replaced by the File tab, which takes you to the new Backstage view. Here you can explore all the options related to your current publication and more. That includes things like recent files, new, and print. It's everything you would have found in the old Office or File menu, except now you have a nice full page view. For example, I like the convenience of being able to adjust the print settings and see a preview all in one place. Now that you know your way around Publisher, including the Backstage view, the ribbon, and the work area, you can start planning your first publication.
Like what you just saw? Rate it.
Add a comment.
Subscribe to our channel.
The freedom to learn.
What you want, when you want.
Absolutely free.
GCF. LearnFree.org